We don't even know we're really killing them. When we start to chase the shiny things, it becomes quite easy to get lost in the glamour and glitz of that world. You'll find yourself always wanting more, which in turn results in you spending all of your money in savings. Number 5, not having a budget. Here's why budgets are great. They help you to plan your money, and this prevents you from buying unimportant things. Every item on your budget is usually something you've thought about for a while. Perhaps an electronic gadget that you purchased recently, a trip you've got planned, or even a payment for a loan. This budget will provide direction. It also gives you an in-depth understanding of your finances. And while most people find it pretty easy to create a budget, the difficult part is sticking to it. If you've got a budget, well, it's like you've never had a budget in the past.
Yo.
We hate to do this, but here's the truth. Ignoring your debt is not going to make it go away. In fact, ignoring your debt is one guaranteed way to make it bigger and become more outlast. You ignore your debt to result in heavy interest rates, which in turn will cause you to pay more than usual. When you pay more than usual, it slowly becomes difficult to pay for other things. So it makes it incredibly hard to save anything. If you don't manage to escape this vicious cycle of debts and interest rates, you would have to work twice as hard just to escape the poverty rate. Number 7, always upgrading your electronic devices. Like it or not, there's always going to be an upgraded version of your electronic devices. Think you've got the coolest microwave oven? There's definitely better than that. Do you use the best and most smartest smartphone? There's definitely going to be an improved and smarter one in just a few months. When you constantly upgrade your electronic devices, you get caught up in this never-ending cycle for an upgrade that you really don't need. Now, while this might seem harmless at first, it could prevent you from saving or from funding your emergency fund account. In fact, it could cause you to default on your loans, a decision with way worse repercussions. Number 8, expecting a miracle. We all hope for miracles, right? It's a common trait to pray and hope that something divine will suddenly change your fortune. And to be honest, there's really no harm in it. However, if a miracle is all you're working for, you might be putting your entire financial future at risk. Not even might, you probably not. Perhaps you believe that you'll someday win the lottery or discover that your grandparents left you an immense fortune and you can suddenly get the best job in the world. But expecting a miracle...
Steph Curry do this, and we talked about it at the time, remember what they went, and we talked about it at the time when it happened, of like, just like, whoa, but this is almost different than anything that, you know, we've done.
It's unheard of, like, he messed up the game in a good way, you know, I think he messed up in a good way, like, he definitely is, I think he hurt the youth, because he was a lot of sleepers, and that's all they were doing, she was great. But you can just see, like, in the league, just how we value the good stuff like that. It's not just something that we just look at, you know, as a spacer, you know, we value it at all populations. We need everybody to make sure you because that's a bread space in the floor, they have a great point draft, we have three guards. So, it's, you know, them and Clay and their whole team, I think, just changed the game in a good or bad way.
I've shown you before we started, my oldest has become obsessed with basketball. And, you know, it's YouTube highlights, started trading basketball cards, which got me into the trick of collecting basketball cards again, too. A very weird thing, but I take him to the gym or I take him to the park two or three times a week. And the first thing he wants to do is check through. Like, and he can barely get it there. And he has to use a smaller ball, but like, that's what he wants to do. And I try to explain to him the value of form shooting. Get under the hoop. And, you know, 10 minutes of form shooting, that's why he needs that. You're right. I think everybody wants to chuck threes. You mentioned the strategy around shooting and three-pointers. And
hindi ka ba maliligo?
Hindi.
Ay, kami, bakit? Bet mo minamadali kami.
Get the paint, make plays, finish the rim, Jalen, you know, getting downhill, Luka getting downhill. And I think that's like one way that 3-point shooting is developed. But I was thinking about you and your sort of development as a shooter. You know, because, you know, when I first got the league, you shot catcher, spot up three. And now it's out of pick and roll and step back and all that stuff. And I'm curious when you started really feeling comfortable with that part of your game.
It's still growing. But I would say that 2016, 17 years after that year in Boston, it was crazy because the next year John got injured. John got hurt and Scotty kind of forced me to become a baller. I was turning the ball over, doing double team, doing all the play through that. I'm just cut the cheeks and kind of hang out and, you know, play like that. I gotta be able to, you know, come up with a high pick and roll and shoot for it. I gotta be able to be there for it. Anyway, that's when it started. And the tough part about it is that it takes a hit, like I said, it's just like a shot. Right? It's not like that. And then to transition, you know, rolling three, getting feet set, like it's sometimes it's the off balance, like you said, shooting a step back, and side steps, like it's sometimes off rhythm, like it's a tougher shot, but it's necessary in the evolution of your game. That's a great point. And that's what a lot of my threes come from.
Yeah, because for someone that guarded you early in your career, and when you played with John, this was when John was healthy and at his best, fastest spot, open court. He's like, where's Brad? And like, find Brad, especially in transition. And of course, I had to chase your ass off screens, and you chased me off screens too. But like, then later on, and I didn't guard you as much late in my career because I was a terrible defender at that point. But later on, seeing that, like, having to guard you in so many different actions and developing that way. And to your point about Steph, like, I think that's where he has gotten so much better. And I think in some ways, like, James Harden also messed up the game a bit. You know what I mean by that?
100%.
Because of
the degrees, ISO, and draw fouls. Those are the three, right? It's those are two great examples. Like, if you're able to see a threat at the 3-point line, if you're a defender, has to expect it. Like, you're always jumping, you're always like, oh, I gotta get that. Like, Steph is a great pass and go type guy. He's a great. He moves well off the ball, so he doesn't mind giving it up. So it's a great package. Very safe and dribble by people. And he looks really good at the same time. And the ability to do it. Manipulate until you draw a foul. Those are game changers, right? But those are what separates you. And I think the next level is being able to shoot further out. Right? You see Dan, you see Steph, even Trey. Trey starts to do a little bit more. And if you do that, now it's okay.
Have you tried adding that to your game?
Yeah,
the deeper.
Yeah. It's a lovely thing. It's a lovely thing, for sure. This is a crazy shot. It is such a crazy little ball of a shot. Really.
Do you jump on it? The deeper?
Yeah.
So that
but I see it from way more arms.
That was always my issue. Shooting, and I could probably get 3 or 4 feet behind the NBA line. Beyond that, I jumped. And then it just became like, and that's where I always tell people this about those three guys. They all, so Trey and Steph basically shoot a push shot. You shoot on the way up, on the way up. and then shoot a push shot, and then he even shoots it off the palm.
Yeah.
That's how he, and he's got, I mean, he's got
he has a great base, too.
Great base. Dame has one of the best bases in the game. But he shoots it off the palm, so he gets a little more distance off that.
Yeah.
So, like, I wouldn't necessarily, like, if I would teach, like, that shooting form, because, right, we were taught to jump, you shoot at the top, and you crawl up where you get elevation, and they shoot different. I think that's what makes them so unique and able to